Heya, it's your favorite bi-yearly Roblox YouTuber here, and I recently have been obsessed with Guts and Blackpowder, and to be honest, it got me back into Roblox. It's such a great game, with such an interesting premise and time period with engaging, well-thought-out, and balanced gameplay, with great voice acting, animation, simple combat, art style, music, level design, community, modeling, and much more. Something I noticed is, why are all the best Roblox devs predominant Christians? Seriously. There are so many things I could talk about that I really wish I could. But if you really want to hear my thoughts about the game, Skit Gaming made a great review on it. The game is not perfect though, and I gotta say the game has been getting a tad bit old to me. And the reason why is that the short supply of maps, and there's not too much variety of play. Of course, you have the 7 classes, but I've used all the weapons in the game extensively, and I've grown tired of them. Something I feel the game could pull off is subclasses, in which a single weapon can change the role of one class entirely. We already have the knotgun that does this for the seaman, turning him from a close-range menace class to a mid-range class that makes zombies alt-tab in a source game every half minute. I think it would be really nifty if we could get weapons like this for all the classes, bringing new ways to play the game. So, you read the title of the video. I have a bunch of weapon ideas for the game that all fit perfectly with the time era of the game, and I'm gonna say them for each class. I'll try and give each class at least one weapon idea, and some classes will have more ideas than others. But before I start, I want to ask you, the viewer, to subscribe. Yeah, it's pretty easy. Please? Alright, here we go. The Powder Keg. Alright, my first idea will be the Powder Keg Backpack. It will cost 100 francs and it explodes on your death. It would be a really funny option to run, and with how lucky we all get, the players we have on our team, we would get a lot of use out of this. Now, if you're dumb and ugly, you would say, well, doesn't this gadget encourage you to die? And to that I say, no. This gadget encourages you to... the dagger. This is probably the least creative idea I've had in this video. The dagger will cost 150 francs, and it gets you out of runner or shambler grab, just like a Resident Evil game. You would only get one of these per game, so you can't just be a dumbass the whole round, and you'd actually have to try and choose whether or not you want to risk wasting this if you get grabbed, and your team is by, but you don't believe in them to save you. Like I usually do. Hatchet. It would cost 300 francs, it would do 30 damage, moderate swing rate, low range, but it would be throwable and it would do 75 damage on a hit, and you'd have to hold E to throw it. Of course, you'd be able to pick it back up. This would be a super fun weapon run. Just imagine getting throw after throw after throw on zombies. I don't think this would be too difficult to code in. Just have it be like the knife throwing from Murder. Hand Mace. It would cost 200 francs, do 35 damage, moderate low swing rate, small range, would not have a down or an up attack, and when fully charged, which would take 3 seconds, the hit would ragdoll or knock the zombies back for 1.5 seconds. This weapon is pretty much a dollar store crucifix, but a weapon. This weapon would probably have the lowest DPS, but would have a lot of supportive utility, knocking zombies down to give you and your team a little extra breathing room. It would also be very good to pair with a sapper to get all the zombies grouped up to be taken out in one big swing. Here's my favorite one. Fists. It would be free, do 20 damage, fast swing rate, low range, headshot slow down zombies by 30% for 2 seconds. Come on, you know you want this a game. I want it. Imagine clocking a run from the mouth. I was kind of out of era appropriate melee ideas, and then I looked down at my own two hands and came up with this idea. I just think it's a fun idea, and I think squaring up was invented in the 19th century. So, yeah. The Wind Busha. I think that's how you pronounce it. This idea was made by Lycanol in the Discord server. It would cost 500 francs, do 50 damage, have 6 rounds, a 20-second reload, medium accuracy, medium penetration, no bayonet, and cannot have its reload speed buffed. I love this idea. Basically, you'd need to go for headshots to get effective use out of this weapon, which is great. I rarely ever go for headshots with guns, because most guns kill with body shots 99% of the time. So a new headhunter's playstyle for the line infantry would be dope. Also, I think headshots only do double damage in the game, meaning you'd have to do a double headshot for zappers. This weapon sounds busted on paper, but I feel like it'd be balanced during gameplay. The long rifle. It would cost 100 francs, do 160 damage, have a 14-second reload, pinpoint accuracy, no damage falloff, high penetration, and take slower to ready. Have you ever been a line infantryman and thought, man, I wish I could be even further away from the zombies? Well, fear not, the long rifle is for you. This would be an anti-sapper sniper gun, essentially, and before you say that the musket is already good enough for sniping, I disagree. At long ranges, even the musket sometimes doesn't kill in one shot due to damage falloff. This weapon would serve a nice niche and would be very useful in survival mode. Okay, I have a lot of ideas for this guy. First pistols. Derringer. It would cost 350 francs, do 65 damage, lower accuracy, low penetration, 5.5 second reload, and after 10 kills with it, you get the whistle ability. To activate it, hold out the derringer and press F. Once activated, all nearby troops get a 35% reload buff for 8 seconds. Stuck. The ability goes on cooldown for 20 seconds after activated. This weapon would turn you into support god for your team. Due to the low damage and accuracy, getting headshots would be tricky but important to rack up kills for this weapon. I really like the idea of this, and giving the officer two different abilities would be really fun to use, and just imagine your whole team machine gunning out rounds for 8 minutes. I mean seconds. Of course, this ability wouldn't be nowhere near as good as the officer's melee abilities, since the melee is basically the officer's primary. The Duckfoot Pistol. It would cost 200 francs, does 65 damage per bullet, low penetration and accuracy, shoots 4 rounds in a vertical pattern, and the crosshair would probably look like this. And it would have a 14-second reload. This is one of the most popular requests to be added in the game. Why wouldn't you want a "we have a seaman at home" weapon for your officer? This gun would just be very good at killing 4 zombies that are conveniently all 1 foot apart from each other. So, if you ever wanted a weapon to kill Weezer, now's your chance! In all seriousness, this weapon would be sick to have, and would be a neat crowd control weapon for the officer. The Pepperbox Revolver. It would cost 400 francs, do 40 damage, have 5 rounds, no penetration, low accuracy, and a 15-second reload. This is a pocket Winbusha. All you gotta do is pop heads to get the most use out of this bad boy. Look, I'm not trying to add too many weapons that are just, oh, a gun we can fire more than one round, but get this, it has a long reload, since all those ideas would just be boring. This weapon just makes too much sense for the officer to have, and I think it would be balanced due to the lack of penetration and the heavy reliance on headshots.
Hey, editing call at Grandma's house here. I came up with a really good idea that I like whilst editing this video. Here it is. It will be the extravagant sword holster. It would give you no pistol at all, but it would increase your charge duration by an extra 5 seconds. I also really like this idea. It would sacrifice a bunch of your own personal damage to benefit your entire team and yourself a little bit.
The Shashka would cost 150 francs, do 35 damage, cannot hit headshots, same swing speed and length as the officer sword, and after 25 kills with, or whatever kill amount the officer saber is, you will get the Endurance Charge ability. Pull out the sword to activate it, and once activated, all nearby soldiers will become completely immune to all damage and grabbing for 7 seconds. On the last 2 seconds of the charge, the orange outline for all players will blink, so the players know when the ability is about to end. It would have a cooldown of 20 seconds. This is the weapon I am most unsure about, so if you have any suggestions for this or any other weapon, please leave a suggestion in the comments below. But I am semi-confident about this idea. It would allow you to completely brute force through pushes and hold out for a little while longer. Whilst you can already do this with the officer charge, you still have to be careful since you're still vulnerable to runners, normal hits, and especially bombers. With this, you wouldn't have to worry about any of that. And last thing about this weapon, it would have a unique activation yell. Here, I'll have my friend Sunko demonstrate what it would sound like. Thank you, Sunko. On to the next class. Violin. It would give all nearby players a 10 or 15% movement speed boost. You would need to keep a line in a hot zone to keep the buff active like this. This would easily be the best sounding instrument in the game to play, and the violin is the most iconic instrument of this time era. I'm not totally sure about its function being super useful, maybe I'm wrong. The flagpole spear. It would do 25 damage, have a low swing rate, long range, and when held out, it highlights everybody in your team near you. Flag changes in whatever country you're in. Duh. This weapon is a pretty neat concept. Now, I know what you're thinking. Well, wouldn't this encourage Fifers to not use their instruments, since this gives his team a buff whilst the Fifer can defend himself? And my response to that is, no. The nearby buff it gives is nowhere near as good as any of the buffs from all the instruments. This would just be a nifty tool to help newer players find their team, and also help to spot teammates who are being grabbed or mauled. Okay, this first idea is really dumb. The hand cannon. It would cost 400 francs, explode on contact, would have a small radius like the grenade, have a low accuracy, 16 second reload, you'd move 20% slower when held out. A really popular request I see is an explosive class to be added in the game. This weapon idea would shut those people up. This weapon sounds busted on paper, but I feel in practice it would be alright. The blunderbuss can already tear through crowds. The cannon would just accomplish the same thing, but in an explosive fashion. This is my second favorite idea. Dual pistols. All the same stats as the officer pistols, except there are two of them. You can cancel the reload after one pistol has been loaded. Pirates and seamen were famous for just having multiple pistols on them instead of rifles or shotguns. This weapon would just be badass and really fun to have in the game. And it would basically turn the seamen into a different class. But hey, we already have the knotgun for that, so why not add this in the game? The special bullet box. It would cost 200 francs, replace the barricade building with a box similar to the bandage box. Can only be placed once per life. Each special bullet would have increased pierce, damage, and accuracy. Each bullet comes with 15 bullets. A player can only collect a maximum of 3 bullets. Once a round has been fired, press B to load in the special bullet. I figured giving the sapper more of a supportive role would be neat to have. It would replace the most useful building in the arsenal with god bullets that would vaporize any zombie. This would be very useful for later rounds in survival or on finales on campaign maps. This thing would reliably help your team secure a couple dozen extra kills per match if they properly utilize the rounds. And last thing, it would stop sappers from making 5-star hotels just like every match I play in survival. The Halberd. It would cost 300 francs, do 100 damage, be a little bit longer, same swing speed as the axe, but it makes you 50% slower when you hold it out. This would be defensive god of weapon, but good luck running away with it or attacking. Spam this at a barricade to get an ungodly amount of kills, but when running away, good luck. The tonic box. Not an alcohol. It's not alcohol. It's soda. It would cost 150 francs. Replace the bandage box. Need supplies to be placed. There will be 9 tonics per box. Every tonic, when used, gives a portable officer charge effect to anyone who uses it. Delays infection for an extra 1 minute, and players can only take 1 tonic even after used. This would give the surgeon an alchemist type role, giving buffs to teammates to get them out of sticky situations. I'm unsure about the infection part, since that probably would conflict with the lore of the game, being that only God can stop the infection, and that zombies are basically demons, but the lore of this game is already shaky. Maybe we should get a comic series on the lore of this game. That would be sick. The Silver Cross. It would cost 600 francs, and it gives you the ability to revive dead teammates for the cost of 35% of your HP. You would not be able to repel hordes with it, and revived teammates come back with half HP. This idea would be pretty balanced, I think. You would have to sacrifice your own health, or possibly your own life, to bring teammates back in the fight. And honestly, I feel like it would fit really well in the game. Imagine sacrificing yourself to save a teammate and having them reach the end. It would make you feel like a hero. Also, revived teammates would receive the full franc reward if they beat the campaign or the badge. Holy Salts. It would cost 200 francs, deals 50 damage, replaces crucifix, quickly throws salt on the zombies, repelling them back for 3 seconds. Has the same cooldown as the crucifix. I also love this idea. It would be a more offensive crucifix that would require more timing in actually aiming it. The hitbox would resemble a cone of you throwing out salt, and any hit zombies would move back, receiving damage at the same time. This last idea is not a weapon idea, but just something basic. But how about a level system that's purely cosmetic and nothing else? By cosmetic, I mean that it shows your level on the leaderboard or by your username. It'd be something fun to grind, and you'd level it up by surviving waves and endless, saving teammates from grabs, or surviving campaigns. Well, that's it for the ideas. If any of these weapon ideas are added in the game, then I would be very humbled and happy. I know the devs like to play it very safe when adding weapons in the game, but I'm worried if I play it safe, that means that we're all going to end up getting a bunch of weapons that blend in with each other in future updates. I don't know. I'm no game dev, alright? Oh, and speaking of which, if you are a game dev watching this, thank you. You helped make one of my favorite Roblox games ever! And you brought countless hours of enjoyment to me and several other millions of people. So thank you. And thank you, the viewer, for watching this. This video took quite a while to make. And hey, I'm proud of it. Anyways, I gotta find a way to get out of the shed alive.